Hello, welcome to another audio commentary for Series 1, Part 1 of Parallel. Today we'll be looking at Part 1 of the final countdown. Maybe not the best title, but it works. Works well enough. This is meant to be the idea of that's a People's Republic announcement. And of course this music is from Sherlock. I just really like the music. Maybe this sequence doesn't quite stand up as good as when I first thought it was, but I do quite like it still. It really sums everything up and brings it together. This idea of this media sort of swarm and attack on Torchwood.
Will Torchwood help us this time?
Of course, all these reporters have been green screened on top of these situations.
The President of the UK is dead.
The President is dead.
Is this due to the recent cyber attacks?
Police are calling his death suspicious.
Suspicious.
I wonder whether or not that article was written by Megan. It could have been.
The commercial world.
Even if she does work for Torchwood, maybe her information, that's how it got to them. Dunno, just speculating there, really.
Number 10 are in talks right now, the future of Torchwood.
Number 10 have announced, due to talks, that Torchwood will be run by the government organization unit.
Run by unit.
And that's it for the opening. That is just it. But like I said, I really wanted to give that impression of the media swarm. That's where this sort of this world is at the moment.
You're making a real habit out of this. What is it I told you last time?
Something about staying out of trouble?
Well then, next time do that.
Let's not be too harsh, Doctor. She's in hospital. How are you feeling?
That's much where I sort of realised that I never mentioned the whole brain freeze
what?
Thing with dream crabs.
When they bury into your
in
skull,
the last episode, so
I think that's enough, thank you, Doctor.
Added
right,
that in
yes,
here.
Sorry, I get carried away. Well, yeah. How's Torchwood holding up?
I quite like the wall, I quite like the bed that I've made out of clearly a cereal box card, but it's that maybe that drawing of all the little
Hello?
Machineries
you
that go above
really
the hospital bed should have been printed rather
governor.
Than drawn.
What's he saying?
Uh-huh, okay. I'll let him know.
What is it?
Me and the doctor will be over straight away. Bad news.
What?
You know the person you spoke to at unit prison to help Claire?
Yes.
Well, he's...
had to include some unit music. Because I love unit music, and I didn't use it enough for the amount of units I used, if that makes sense.
What happened? Well, Doctor!
This character actually disappears and is never seen again after this. I imagine he did so badly he probably got fired by units.
What sort of organisation is this? You're meant to be better than Torchwood, that's why you took over.
Doctor, calm down.
Thank you. So, what's the next step? We were going to leave that to you and Torchwood. Doctor, you have had previous experience with the trader, and of course you know the professor. You don't mean our professor. This was his new job. Yes, James wanted someone he could trust to watch over the trader and find out all he knew. Let me see. Why have you got Credorin? It was used on the prisoner. Thought so. Do you know what this does? I was told it was a true serum.
Now this set doesn't quite
90s.
Look as good
oh,
now that I've used daylight compared to when I first lit it
that's
in the last episode with
again.
The red light.
Okay, maybe
but of course I had to make it look different
climate,
like the day after.
Safe,
or the morning
space,
after it, sorry.
This is lethal. Maybe it's quite sure why, but it breaks away your neurons in the brain until you have no brain function left.
Maybe this was a little bit contrived, but I wanted to try and make the trader even more dangerous than what he'd already was.
Oh no. Precisely. Well done,
Governor. So Rolling Stones music. I just thought it fitted Horace's character, and I had the idea of him breaking into Torchwood at the end of the story.
So,
with Paint It Black playing.
I
am actually slightly disappointed that I never included the music again in Series 2 when he appears in that final, but,
you won't last the torture much longer, so tell me. Then you leave me no choice, because it's not just me that wants
but this information.
I think, you know,
I think it works here, whatever anyone says.
I won't enjoy this. Wait. Yes, I will. Not long now, and I can take you out for the first spin.
Yep, so this is the Doctor getting closer and closer to being able to actually fly in the TARDIS.
You sent for me, Doctor?
You might be wondering why it's a police box. Because, of course, he's growing a new TARDIS. Why is it a police box? But it is technically a clone of the original box because it's made from a piece of the original Doctor's box. So, I don't know. I couldn't not have it as
what
a police box anymore.
Wow.
It just seems wrong.
Yours.
So,
for my research.
It's the old file room. James is meaning to do something with it for a while.
And
so
this is where I use the
well,
Bill music for Megan,
it's all been backed
which
up
is
here.
As well something
as all
I tried to do a little bit of in Series 2, but
now
a little bit less because it's a bit
jarring
in Series
1. That you also look into Claire for me. This file really confuses
This is where the file was a little bit different because I've added that sort of fade between Claire and Rose, which is a little bit of a nod to the Trickster
right
episodes in
Thank you, Megan.
From Sarah Jane Adventures. Of course, that's very similar to what happened with the Sabine, but the whole idea is it trying to get everyone to realise that it is the thing, probably a little bit quicker than the Doctor gets it.
A spaceship has crash landed in the centre of London. What would be the response from Torchwood, and will the People's Republic interfere? That's all we need, more media attention. Right, you keep working on, I'll find out what's happening. Doctor, grab your coat. Unit have brought something out of the wreckage. We need to find out what it is. If pain doesn't loosen your tongue,
of course that
maybe this stuff
is really dangerous to the professor as
right.
Well, because
I'll tell you.
Only at this point
the
had I realised
no
that I was going towards
to
the idea that the professor
the
was a Time Lord as well.
Unwanted company. An illusion? What kind? Only when
yes,
you're
this idea
cares,
of not being able to get
through
Torchwood was a little bit
lost,
of a retcon. However, it did have
not.
Some repercussions.
Thank you, professor.
During the last episode
you're
with
going
the
to have to join
Dream
me.
Yes, of course, this is all green screened, but I don't think it looks too bad. One of my first voices of somebody
Clarence,
else, which is my
just
friend, who voices Charlie
in
Series 2, actually,
careful,
just to give a little bit of a difference in the voices here. I like that joke.
Torchwood snobs.
Because I like that idea that UNIT and Torchwood don't really like each other, at least in this universe. Again, this is me trying to do a different
Mr.
voice,
Black
so that's why he's got such a stupid,
to find you. Where is
almost
it?
Irish accent.
Sergeant Park, sir, this way. I have
I had
to
include Bessie in here somewhere, because the Doctor's on Earth, it has so many connotations to John Pertwee's era.
What is
and I made Bessie.
James,
I know it's out of cardboard.
Bessie. As you requested, Doctor.
Which is actually the real name of the car
roadster.
That the
Ward.
Third Doctor has. That is an Edwardian roadster.
Torchwood.
Canary.
You didn't think just asking
roadster.
Megan for a job was enough, did you? But that's
I love that joke
money.
About the tax
we
as well.
Enough,
just the unit doesn't
now,
care. Because, of course, the Torchwood is run by the Crown, whereas unit is run by the government.
I was told to bring you all the new documents.
That is actually how it is
database.
In Doctor Who.
So here is Mark's old things that have just arrived from America.
Mark?
He used to work here.
Of course, Megan
Central
doesn't
North
know
America,
about
America,
Mark,
hush, hush,
which
that.
Is why I had to have somebody explain
James
that to her.
It,
but
anyway,
I thought it was good to have
oh,
Clark as
yeah,
one of the unexpected Sabines.
I'll let the Brigadier explain this one to you.
I hope people realise
right,
I said this in the episode 5 review. This isn't
no,
the
don't.
Brigadier,
I'm
even though this is my Brigadier custom at the time. I have a Brigadier figure now. But, this isn't the Brigadier, it's a Brigadier.
So, as I was saying,
obviously.
This needs hostile action immediately. They're getting it all wrong, you know. Oh yeah, you don't think we're under attack from aliens? You're new here, aren't you?
Second official day on the job. They called me up and told me about an organisation that deals with aliens. Of course, I didn't believe them at first.
You haven't been reading the papers then?
No, not really.
I'm the Doctor, by the way. What's your name?
Tracy.
Nice to meet you, Tracy. What's your opinion, Blackmore? I think it depends on what we're dealing with.
This is a bit of a mistake
pain?
Here. I didn't realise that I hadn't actually got a shot of everybody looking at the pig after the blanket had been taken off. I don't know what happened. Some footage got deleted. That's why some of that doesn't quite edit together properly.
You need clearance to see this patient, sir.
Don't be ridiculous.
That's actually the same doctor that saw Megan's mum as she was dying in the last episode. That was just because I had the figure to the side. I used it again for this. And I actually do quite like that space pig figure, so I had to include it somewhere in my animation. Tord of Marks sings. I was going for the idea that he was a bit of a comic book fan.
If you're watching this, then they have got to me. I'm probably
I
six
like the
feet
idea,
under.
The premise
I'm
of this,
this video
with Mark's
to tell
message,
everyone that Torchwood
but I think the execution could have been
danger.
A bit better. And of course, everything's now leading to the ending of this
Looking
part.
In, why is that?
Everything's coming the together,
last
it's
leading,
into leading
the
to a climax.
Colonization of Sabine around America, and I have found
I
out
think
about
it, I think it's got
truth.
A reasonably good
cliffhanger. Sabine, of course!
Of course, that's done with series of photographs
America,
that I've edited with
paint.net
to have that line come across
well,
his forehead. Because if I did that now,
twice.
I'd be able to do that so much better. And actually, something that I did better in part two by the light. There we go. I did the light there with Megan. Rather than showing the zip, I decided to just do it with light. And here's my machine gun, my favourite machine gun sound. So I wanted this idea, and I did nick this idea a little bit from Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., but this idea that anybody could be a Sabine, and so they've taken over this whole organisation, and not just Torchwood, but UNIT as well, and the government, and everywhere. Can't trust anyone, that's what Mark says, and that's what I wanted to go for.
I warn you to move out of the way.
One of my favourite ever episodes of Doctor Who is the sound of drums, and I'll talk about some of the connections the next part has to that.
Don't
and I love
trust
that shadow on the wall of Sabine. See, now, in my mind, this idea of the music starting works a little bit better than it does in the episode, but I still quite like the music. That green screen wall. It's not bad. My one problem with Horus has soldiers working for him, but of course they are Sabine in suits. They aren't just soldiers, but it's never really mentioned. And here he is. Horus has finally broken into Torchwood properly, and he's now in charge.
Thank you, dear.
Poor professor.
Can you
again,
smell
that?
That
music could have hit harder, but I didn't quite do it right. To be continued. No next time trailer. So, thank you so much for watching. That's another commentary, Dan. I'll be moving on to part 2 next, so please check that out when it's available. I've done the whole of series 1 so far, so please check those out as well, as well of course the original animations. If for some reason you haven't watched those first, please go watch those. I'll be moving on to series 2 next, so thank you again for watching, and goodbye.